Waken, Gwyn!
Yeah. The little ones have been up to their old tricks again.
Not all of the nobles made it out alive.
Otto, is now a good time?
It's not a bad one. How's Jill doing?
Oh, she's been better. Ty is making sure she gets the rest she needs.
Good.
Any word on Kupka's movements?
Vivian's doing what she can to try and track him, but she's feeding on scraps. We've sent owls out to the Cursebreakers and our other friends in the West, asking them to keep their eyes peeled for anything unusual. No leads yet, but it's only a matter of time.
All right. Let me know when you find something.
There he is. All right, Clive. Still busy saving the world.
Mid. When did you get back?
Just now.
What about your studies?
Adjourned. Since Hugo Kupka invaded Rosaria, all the canvas in uproar about it. He's gone mad. He's turned rogue. It'll be us next. You try concentrating with all of that.
All right. You win.
How long will you be staying this time?
Dunno. A while, most likely. Any road, while I'm here, I was hoping you could do us a favour.
Mid, you can't just expect me to...
Please, oblige her. While we are busy tracking down Kupka, you should have a little time to spare.
Professor! Now there's a face I haven't seen in a while. Shouldn't you have it buried in a dusty old tome?
I did, till a familiar trill pricked my ears. As ever, your exuberance is a breath of fresh air, which successfully scattered the painstakingly assembled fragments of my thoughts.
I'll take that as a compliment. Well, Clive, you heard the professor. So, I'll meet you in the storeroom when you're done.
Wait, hold on! Breath of fresh air. Bloody tempest, more like. Oi, Otto, you got my gill. Huh? What are you on about?
My fee for bringing Mid across. She said you were paying.
That little...
The storeroom, was it? I wonder what Mid's plotting.
Visiting hours are over, Your Lordship.
Shouldn't you be getting some rest soon?
You took your time.
I'm a busy man, Mid.
I'll get to the point then. I want to turn the room down there into a workshop, like the one I had at Dad's place.
Mid, you've only just come back.
And? I've been thinking about it for a while. Dad said I had a knack for engineering. Told me everything he knew about it. Then sent me off to Canva to learn everything he didn't. That was his dream for me. That one day I'd put my studies to use for the good of the cause. But I'm helping no one stuck at school. I've studied enough. It's time I put my neck to work. I know that I can help the people here, and I want to do it.
Well. As sick could see you now. All right. I'll tell Otto you'll be staying.
I knew you'd say yes. Which is why I wrote up a list of jobs for you.
For me?
Who else?
What do you want me to do?
First things first, I need equipment and materials to start making my own. There's the designs for the stuff I need, and the stuff it needs smithing from. The other materials I can work myself. Just need a generous benefactor to lay them on for me. Apart from the wood, I'll need a carpenter for that, but I can just borrow yours.
Is that everything?
For now. I'll let you know if I need aught else.
path. Materials and tools. That means Karen and Blackthorn.
Jill looked white as a sheet when we caught her.
Was wondering where you'd got to. Mid's back from Canver. Have you seen her?
Just now. She's planning to set up a workshop in the stores and ask me to buy her some materials. Here's the list. Think you can find everything on there?
This lot? Would be much of a trader if I couldn't.
Excellent. As for payment?
It's paid. 100 times over by what that girl's done for us. If it weren't for her filters, we'd have nought to drink but blight water, and that would have drained the life out of us long ago.
Indeed it would.
I'll send the stuff on to Mid when it comes in.
Thank you, Karen. Blackthorn, you busy?
What's it look like?
I have a commission for you, from Mid. She requires certain tools. Do you think you can make them?
Bloody hell. What's she planning to build with this stuff? An airship? I'll see what I can do. Till I bring them over when I'm done.
My thanks. And Mid's, no doubt. That just leaves the carpenter. Let's see if Bardolph's available.
What do you need? What do you want?
And what can I do for you? It'd better all be here. You're rubbing me blind, you know. I reckon I can find a buyer. Come again. Or don't. I'm not... bothered either way.
Good oiling, this could...
should be enough to...
How do, Master Cid?
Bardolph. Mid's looking to build a workshop in the storeroom, and she needs the aid of a skilled carpenter. So naturally I thought of you.
Well, I'd love to help the young miss however I can, but I'm afraid I got my hands full just keeping this place afloat. There's holes need patching, and if I don't patch them, will all of us sink into the mere? I'd gladly spare Mid all the time I have, but the sad truth is, I ain't got none.
I see.
It don't have to be me, though, does it? What about that other fella? You know, the one over at Martha's Rest. Bernard, was it?
That's right. And he is a friend of the cause. I'll ask Martha if she can spare him. Thank you, Bardolph.
Least I could do.
Clive, what brings you to the Rest?
Our home finds itself in need of an extra carpenter. I wondered if I might be able to borrow Bernard for a short while.
I don't mind if he don't. We're all friends here, aren't we?
Thank you, Martha. Do you know where I might find him?
He went up to Cressida on business. No idea what, mind. The place is a ruin. Far as I know, he's still there.
I'll look for him there, then. Thank you.
this one.
Stay down!
Get him! All yours, Trouble! Go for it!
Yeah. If it ain't the lad who saved my life. What brings you to a place like this?
You do, Bernard. Martha said I might find you here. I have a proposition for you.
Oh, do you now? Building a workshop, you say? Well, that beats tacking boards to bridges, sure enough. And if Martha didn't mind me being gone a while, then neither do I. You just tell me where you want me.
That's the spirit.
I couldn't ask a favor, though, could I? Before we go?
Of course.
Well, that there is Cressida, where I grew up. Ain't much left of it now, though. Except my parents' graves. But I came up here hoping to visit. I even patched up the bridge to get across. Only to find the place crawling with fiends. But you're a dab hand when it comes to dealing with beasts and bogles, ain't you? Any chance you could...
It's the least I can do.
Well, thank you kindly. And take care.
This shouldn't take long. Should do it.
You made short work of that lot. Thank you, son. Now my folks can rest in peace once more.
How long is it since the village was abandoned?
Well, people started packing their things after the duchy fell. Between the Blight and the Imperials, you just couldn't make ends meet. Must be nigh on a decade since the last wagon left. Though it may as well have been a century, looking at the place. This isn't the Cressida I remember.
I'm sorry.
Ah, don't be. Can't live in the past, no matter how nice it might have been. Soon as I'm done saying a prayer for those that raised me, it's onto your hideaway. I'll meet you there.
That should take care of Mid's little list. Better head back before she thinks of anything else.
I'm sorry I didn't come back to see you.
Littlins have been up to their old tricks again. Drawing. The Deccans.
Shouldn't you be getting some rest?
All right, Clive. You've all done then.
I am. I've placed your various orders, and a carpenter by the name of Bernard is on his way from Martha's Rest.
That's brilliant. Thanks, Clive.
Is there anything else you need?
Nope. Blackthorn and Lady Karen have already sent over everything I asked for, and I've got all my plans drawn up. So as soon as Bernard gets here, we can get to work. I can't wait.
That's my good deed for the day done. Let's see how Jill's faring.
Ah, Clive.
Talia. How's Jill?
Recovering, but she still needs her rest.
Of course. Take good care of her, won't you?
I'll do my best. Oh, Gav was looking for you. He said he had something to show you in the shelves.
The shelves? Ah, that's right. He went to ask Harpocrates about Torgul. He must have found something. You have the look of a man with the twins upon his shoulders, Rodrigue.
Talia has tasked me with removing a Cursebreaker's brand. But it's my first time, and I don't think I can do it. I'm afraid of what happens if I fail. You survived, I know, but near as many die as recover. Is it really worth the risk?
You don't need me to answer that. You know full well what we're fighting for. I hope as much as you that one day bearers can walk among others as equals. But until that day, a brand is a burden, and we must lift that burden in order to go undetected. The operation may be dangerous, but it's also essential, and we undergo it willingly.
I know. I still wish there was some other way. Griping about my lot helps no one, I suppose. Don't worry. I'll do what must be done.
I know you will.
Unfortunately, the first thing that needs doing is the preparation of a draught to dull the pain. Something I can't do with the infirmary's ammonia supply so low. What few leaves we have would barely be enough for removing a splinter, let alone a brand.
Just tell me what you need.
You'll go? Oh, thank you. No one knows herb lore like Talia, and she swears by ammonia for easing pain. It's simple enough to find, if you know where to look. And fortunately for you, I do. Along the river near the village of Amber over in Rosaria. Just search for the bright blue blossoms.
Expecting you back so soon.
Litlands have been up to their old tricks again.
Do you have a moment, Cid? A team of curse breakers has gone missing near Northreach.
Which team?
Coles. They were sent to liberate a carriage of bearers before they could be smuggled to market. They were moving in for their assault when the carriage was attacked by goblins. A cursebreaker managed to release a Stolas amid the confusion, but this was days ago. They should be back by now, but I've heard nothing from any of them. I can't help but worry that
they know the work is dangerous. But I'm sure they're fine.
But what if I've got them all killed? Before they go out, I always remind them why we're doing this, what they escaped, and what we're freeing people from. But I never really thought how my words might affect them. What risks they might take because of the things I've said.
I'll go and find them. We'll both rest easier knowing they're safe.
Thank you, Cid. And I'm sorry to trouble you with this. The plan was to intercept the slaver somewhere in the Dragon's Eyrie. I can't tell you much more than that, I'm afraid.
That should be enough to go on. If they were there, Torgal will track them down.
Jill looked white as a sheet when they brought her back.